Good evening, children. Today we are going to learn 9th chapter, models. Models. Models are verbs used to express the mood or attitude of the speaker. They are also known as model auxiliaries. Examples: can, could, will, would, shall. Models are used to give advice, make suggestions, make polite requests, to seek or give permission, and to give invitations. The most commonly used models are can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, must, ought to, dare, need. What are the features, characters? That is, models are types of verbs. Models are types of verbs. They can be used only in helping form. They cannot be used as the main verb in a sentence. They do not have ing or ed forms. Models do not change forms according to the number and person of the subject. They help to express ability, possibility, permission, and obligation. Now coming to the possibility, ability, can, could, be able to. So if you want to express this possibility, ability, you can use can, could, be able to. Can is used to express ability or to state that something is possible. Rita, that is example, he can swim across the river very fast. That is ability. Rita can come across in the evening. Rita can come here in the evening if she is free. Possibility. A gymnast can somersault easily. That is ability. A gymnast can somersault easily. That is ability. Then second one, can also, it has only two forms. Can has only two forms. Can, present, and could, past. Here, I can make delicious fruit salad. That is present. I could dance well in my childhood. That is past. And be able to, it can be used in all tenses. The negative form of can is cannot, that is can't, you can write short form. Sometimes it is possible to use be able to in place of can. He is able to speak French. He can speak French. Other way, two ways are correct only. And the mechanic has not been able to repair the washing machine. I will not be able to accompany you to the market today. So can, could, possibility, ability, capacity to do something in the present or past. So be able to, possibility, ability at all times. This is the difference. It will have tense, the present or past, but this is at all times. Here is a list of few things that your best friend can do, or he or she can't do. Frame complete sentences using the models can or can't. Models can or can't. Now, draw pictures, make sandwiches, sing, play cricket or table tennis, swim, ride a bicycle, dance, narrate stories. So you have to use these 8, then you should make a sentences. That is, my best friend can draw pictures but can't make sandwiches. Okay. Second sentence, my best friend can sing but she can't play cricket or table tennis. My best friend can ride a bicycle, but she can't swim. My best friend can dance, but she can't narrate stories. So all these things are like this, you can join. You can start by writing, my best friend can draw pictures, but she can't make sandwiches, like this, how we did now. Now complete these sentences using can or be able to, or use can if possible, otherwise use be able to. So whatever it is, that is fill in the blanks, you see that which will then suitable for, which is suitable for that sentence. Trekking dash be very dangerous if one does not know its technique. Trekking can be very dangerous if one does not know its technique. We will dash come back in 2 hours. We will be able to come back in 2 hours. My friend dash help me if she wants to. My friend, that is can. My friend can help me if she wants to. I dash to visit your house today. I will be able to visit your house today. He dash cut wood easily when he was young. He was able to cut wood easily when he was young. That is Manu dash row a boat easily before he met with an accident. Ramu said that Manu could, or he was able, Manu was able to row a boat easily before he met with an accident. The next one, asking for things. When you are asked, can, could, may, will. To ask for things, we generally use can or could. Can I borrow your pen? Can I read your book, please? Could you make a cup of tea, please? Could you bake a cake for me, please? Rohan to his colleague, may I drive your car today? Doctor to the nurse, may I have the patient's blood report? So may is also possible, but being very formal is it is not preferred. However, we can use will if we like. Will you switch on the TV, please? Can, informal, may, formal, could, very polite. So if it is for informal, we can use can, formal, that is may. Then very polite means could. The choice depends on the situation and the speaker's relation with the listener. Now see, take the appropriate models, consider the speaker and the person being addressed while using the models. Aunt said to Rita, can, could, may, you bring a glass of orange juice for me? Can you bring a glass of orange juice for me? Parul said to her mother, can, could, may, that is, you make a hot chocolate for me, please. Varun said to her mother, could you make hot chocolate for me, please? The old man said to the stranger, can, could, may, you show me the way to the post office. So which is correct? That is, the old man said to the stranger, can you show me the way to the post office? Fourth one, Pranav said to his boss, can, could, may, I leave early today. So what is the may I leave early today? The class monitor to the teacher, I have collected all the answer sheets. Can, could, may, I keep them in your drawer? May I keep them in your drawer? Aruna said to her brother, can, could, may, I borrow your roller skates today? Aruna said to her brother, can I borrow your roller skates today? Vikram said to his brother, can, could, may, I wear your jacket today as mine is dirty. So Vikram said to his brother, can I wear your jacket today as mine is dirty? Aditya said to his brother, you can, could, may, take it from the cupboard. So Aditya said to his brother, you can take it from the cupboard. Asking for and giving permission. Asking for permission and giving permission. May, can, and could. It is Sami's birthday party, and his friends have gathered for the celebration. Mother, Samir, now we can cut the cake. Samir, Mama, can I eat a large piece of the chocolate cake? Mother, yes, you can. You can serve cake and wafers to your friends. Manas, Samir, can I have some more cake? Samir, sure, you can. Mother, Samir, can you look after your friends? Ravi, Auntie, may I have some more wafers? Mother, yes, you may, Ravi. Could you switch on the fan, please? The switchboard is right behind you. Samir, Mama, can I distribute the return gifts now? Mother, yes, you can do that now. Ravi, Auntie, may I leave now? I have to go out with my parents. Mother, oh, sure, you may. So these are the things that is conversation. And now coming to D, exercise. That is, here is a conversation between a teacher and two students. Use may, can, or could to fill in the blanks. Teacher, sit quietly and take out your notebooks. Samarth, ma'am, can I drink water? Or for that, it is better if you write, may I drink water? Because the teacher. So, ma'am, may I drink water? Teacher, yes, you can. We all can go and play in the ground after you complete the exercise. Samarth, ma'am, could you allow us to carry our water bottles to the ground? Teacher, you all can do so. So this is the thing, and could and was able to. So could also suggests a general ability in the past or permission to do something. Was able to suggest ability in a particular situation. So that is the difference. It requires, was able to request a particular situation. And when I was a little girl, I could easily climb trees. That is general ability. I could watch the play because I had booked my tickets earlier. So this also general ability. And she was able to get into the bus because it was not overcrowded. This is in a particular situation, was able. That is crowded position. No? The boy could paint well and he had won many prizes in the past. So this one could paint. That is also ability. And fill in the blanks with the could, couldn't, or was able to. Now, first one. Although the shop was crowded, she was able to reach the counter within minutes. Was able to. He dash win a gold medal because he had practiced weightlifting with dedication. He was able to win a gold medal because he had practiced weightlifting with dedication. He did not have her mobile number, so he dash contact her. That is, couldn't. He did not have her mobile number, so he couldn't contact her. She is knowledgeable, so she dash discuss the details of important scientific inventions. She is knowledgeable, so she could discuss the details of important scientific inventions. She dash prepare delicious pasta because she had joined cookery classes. She could prepare or was able to, because it is a particular situation, that is a pasta, preparing delicious pasta. So then she was able to prepare delicious pasta. So that is, she was able to prepare, that is a particular situation. No? She was able to prepare delicious pasta because she had joined cookery classes. Now E, look at the pictures and frame sentences with could, couldn't, or was able to. The policeman dash catch the thief because he was alert. The policeman was able to catch the thief because he was alert. The particular situation it is. The thief dash escape as he was caught Got a, that is a unawares. The thief, what is this here? Couldn't. The thief couldn't escape as he was caught unawares. And then third one, the lady dash read the newspaper without spectacles because she had a good eyesight. The lady could read the newspaper without spectacles because she had a good eyesight. The lady dash to keep herself informed about current events because she read the newspaper regularly. The lady, that is, was able to, the lady was able to keep herself informed about current events because she read the newspaper regularly. Could is used to make suggestions. What shall we do? What shall we do? A couple is discussing something important here. A guest is expected for dinner at Mrs. and Mr. Gupta's house. They discuss their plans. We could take our guest, that is, out for a dinner. I could prepare Indian food at home. We could order food from outside. We could order Chinese food from a restaurant, that is, could. The next one is G. Imagine you are the coach of a football team. Give five suggestions to a footballer of the team preparing to participate in an upcoming football match. Use the clues given below and the model could to give suggestions. The first one has been done for you. You could go jogging every morning to improve your stamina. Exercise regularly. Then you could exercise regularly to stay fit. Third, you could practice kicking a ball into the goal post again and again. You could practice kicking a ball into the goal post again and again. Then you could take a proper diet for strong muscles. Fifth one, you could watch the recording of good football matches played in the past to improve your own technique. Now, possibility, that is may, might, could. May, might, could. So where is a kitty? Kitty could be under the bed. She might be in the garden. She may be sleeping in the basket. Both may and might are used to suggest possibility, but might suggest a weaker possibility than may. It is a weak, which one might. Could may also be used in these sentences. She could be in the garden, could suggest a still weaker possibility because she could be in the garden means it is not definite. And could suggest a very weak possibility, may suggest a good possibility, and might also suggest a weak possibility only. Now, fill in the blanks. This exercise, that is H, fill in the blanks with the may, might, or could. If it does not rain, she dash come here. What is it? If it does not rain, she might come here. The flight dash not take off because of a bad weather. The flight could not take off because of a bad weather. One day, man dash live on Mars. One day, man, that is, might live on Mars. Then the tiger dash become extinct in a few years' time. The tiger may become extinct in a few years' time. The princess dash be in trouble because her bodyguards are not to be seen. Princess then might be in trouble because her bodyguards are not to be seen. So next one, could and could have. How to use could and could have? Could refers to the present in some cases, some sentences, and could have refers to some moment in the past. That is a present could. It is a moment in the past. Example, I was so happy. I could have jumped and danced with joy at some moment in the past. Second one, I am so happy. I could jump and dance with joy. So these are the two sentences. This is some moment and this is a that is present. I am so happy. That is present tense. And we also use could have or talk about things which were possible but did not happen. Did not happen. So in that time, she was careless while chopping vegetables. She could have cut her finger. Could have done at some moment in the past, but did not do. Could do at the present moment. And fill in the blanks with the could or could have plus a suitable verb. So here, that is, he did not sing at the concert. He dashed the audience easily with his melodious voice. Impress. How you would write? Impress. That is, here the yeah. He did not sing at the concert. He dashed. What is which is correct? That is, we can use could have plus a suitable verb. What impress? Could have. What we can write? That is, could have plus a then. Impress. He did not sing at the concert, and he could have impressed, isn't it? And the next one, that is, she dashed late for the flight if she had not rushed. That is a B. Then what is that B? Here, that is, she dashed. She could have been late for the flight if she had not rushed. Then next one is, that is, the driver was in a great hurry. Then he dashed the red light. He could have skipped. That is, the driver was in a great hurry. He could have skipped the red light. Then the next one is, the children were so eager to meet their favorite cricketer that they dash him from all sides. They could have surrendered him from all. The children were so eager to meet. That is, first could have surrendered. So this is could have surrendered. See children, he did not sing at the concert. That is, first one is he could have impressed. Second one is she could have been. Because only B they have given here, she could have been late. She could have been late for the flight if she had not rushed. Third one is the driver was in great hurry. And he could have skipped. Fourth one, that is, we are using could have plus a suitable verb. That is, and last one is could have surrendered. Could have surrendered. The next one is maybe, might be, may have, might have. Rohan said, Reena may be in her study, maybe. Rita said, Rashi might be in the playground. Mohan said, Suresh may have left the house for office. And Preeti said, Sagar might have changed his plans to go out. Now read the given questions and answer them with the help of clues provided. There is a message for Meena. Do you know where she is? May, might be, conference room. So what is that? She might be in the conference room. Do you know why the flight was cancelled? That is, may, might, runway, damage. Maybe because the runway is damaged. Do you know where my wallet is? May, might, be, that is, cupboard. It might be in the cupboard. Vinita's friend has come to meet her. Where is she? May, might, watching TV in the other room. She may be watching TV in the other room. Necessity, compulsion, must have, that is, have to, here, necessity, compulsion, must, have to, have got to, had got to. So all these things. We use a have to and a must to say that that's necessary to do something. Sometimes we can use either of them. We can use have to or must to. Must. So that is a, for must to won't come. You must study sincerely if you want to score good marks. You have to study sincerely if you want to do well. So these are the thing. Must, that is not to only. You must study. Here, you have to. Have will follow to. How to is used to suggest some kind of a compulsion or there is some rule which has to be followed or the situation requires it. You must spend time with your children. I want to do that. And you have to sign the register when we enter this building. That is the rule. Understood? That is, I can't jog for too long. I have to take a break. The situation demands that I take a break. So must doesn't have a past tense form. So we can use must to talk about the present or the future. So must, we must attend the meeting now, present. We must attend the meeting tomorrow. That is future. But we can use have to in all tenses. I had to buy medicine from the chemist shop. That is past. Then I have to buy medicine from the chemist shop, present. I will have to buy medicine from the chemist shop. That is future. In questions and the negative sentences with how to, we normally use do, does, did. Do you have to work till late every day? Did the students have to carry their identity cards? We often use have to, but we can also use have got to instead of have to. We have got to complete the project by next week. I have got to take my medicine before I leave for office. So have got to, had got to can be used in place of have to or had to. Must. Must is used when the speaker insists something has to be done. Then have to or had to is used to suggest external, that is compulsion, and some kind of a rule or the demand of the situation. Now complete these sentences with a must or have to, had to. Sometimes it is possible to use either must or have to. She dash carry her passport as she is going abroad. So what, which is correct? She, that is going, she must carry her passport as she is going abroad. You dash taste the cake. It is freshly baked. You have to taste the cake. It is freshly baked. We cannot travel as she is sick. We will dash postpone the trip. We cannot travel as she is sick. Then we have to postpone the trip. The policeman dash use water cannon when the crowd became unruly. The policeman had to use water cannon when the crowd became unruly. So past tense became unruly. My neighbor dash break open the door as he lost his keys. My neighbor had to break open the door as he lost, because this is past tense, we have to use past tense only. Then suggestion, advice, duty, obligation, should, ought to. Now, Ravi, your eyesight has become weak. You should eat carrots. You should also go for an eye checkup. I will do that. So here, and here, that is, we use should to make a suggestion or to give advice. Should is not as strong as must or have to. Look at this example. You should exercise every day. It is right. It is the right advice for you. We must carry the driving license while driving any vehicle. It is an advice for you. You have to drink a lot of water during summer to avoid dehydration. And make sentences with the group of words given below. Use a should, must, or have to with each sentence. Then that is with each sentence. That is, go for a walk regularly. You should go for a walk regularly. Visit a dentist. You must visit a dentist. Then charge your mobile phone. You have to charge your mobile phone. Then lock the door properly. You must lock the door properly. Then inform the class teacher about any change of address. So you must inform the class teacher about any change of address. So the next one, complete here. Mustn't, don't, have to. You mustn't hit your pet. And it is necessary that you don't hit your pet. Example, you don't have to give any money to beggar. There is no need to give any money to beggars, but if you want to, you can. Don't, doesn't, have, that is, suggest no need, no need to do, but do it if you like. Mustn't. Mustn't suggest some obligation, don't do. Complete these sentences with the mustn't or don't or doesn't have to. You dash follow your role models blindly. You mustn't follow your role models blindly. We dash eat food with dirty hands. We mustn't eat food with dirty hands. The next one, the girl dashed the plane outside in the sun as she would get a heat stroke. The girl. Then, so here, third one, the girl. Then mustn't. The girl mustn't play outside in the sun as she would get a heat stroke. She dash pay the telephone bills in cash always. She can pay through credit card also. She doesn't have to pay the telephone bills in cash always. She can pay through credit card also. We dash play loud music while the children are studying. We mustn't play loud music while the children are studying. Then now, should have. Should have done means that it would be the right thing to do, but it wasn't done. So, Pearl should have informed the teacher that she had not completed her assignment. Complete these sentences. Complete these sentences with the should have plus verb in appropriate form given in the brackets. Mohit dash his mother that he had lost his wristwatch in school. Mohit, that is, should have told his mother that he had lost his wristwatch in school. Mother dash the maid to keep away from electrical appliances. Mother then should have warned. Mother should have warned the maid to keep away from electrical appliances. The gardener dashed the children to keep away from flower pots. The gardener should have told the children to keep away from the flower pots. Then Garima dash permission from her parents before going out with the friends. The lady dash all the necessary documents before applying for a loan. The lady should have submitted all the necessary documents before applying for a loan. Now promise plus. Promise, that is a plus will, shall. So the will and shall are used to convey some kind of a promise or assurance. Will with I, that is a, and shall, that is with other subjects, suggest a promise. We will join you for dinner, promise. We shall be then provided with all the modern facilities in this apartment, assurance. However, these days are generally used will with all subjects to refer to future tense, future time. But will with I and that is we enough to suggest a promise. We should say, I promise I will. We assure you we will. So ought to. So ought to means here, ought to conveys that it should be the right thing to do with a greater sense of responsibility and as a moral duty. Here, you ought to look after your grandparents. You ought to pay the taxes on time. Ought all to also suggest that is the right thing to do. Nowadays, both should and ought to are used to, that is commonly, that is for the same idea. Then to convey the same idea, should is used for giving suggestion, advice, general, mild. Must suggest the speaker insists something is done. And ought to indicates a moral obligation to do something, and should have suggest that something was right to do but was not done. Request, can, could, will, would. Can and could are used more often than will and would. Could and would are more polite than will and can. Can you switch on the fan? Could you make some lemonade for me? Can, could, commonly used to make a request, then could, would, more polite than can and will. Imagine the situation described below and use can, could, or will, would to make a request in each case. Your neighbor is playing very loud music and you are preparing for your science test. Then you start this way, uncle, could you play the music low as I'm preparing for a science test? Second, an old man has parked his car in the middle of the road and it is blocking your way. Then would you park your car, that is, on the left side, as it is blocking my way? You have just finished your dinner at a restaurant and you have to pay the bill. Could you bring the bill to be paid? Your father has bought a laptop and paid the money. He has to get a receipt. Could he give the receipt of the paid amount? Your lady is standing. That is at the entrance of a chemist shop and you are in a hurry to get to buy medicine. What will you say? Could you give me way as I am in a hurry? Now, prohibition, mustn't, ought not to. You mustn't talk in the library. It is prohibited. You ought not to throw stones at animals. It is not right to. Then you ought not to talk rudely with the elders. So these are things. And the model mustn't suggest prohibition. Ought not means more like shouldn't. So ought not suggest that something, that doing something won't be right. Must not, that is used to convey a prohibition to do something. Fill in the blanks with the mustn't or ought not to. You dash, that is mustn't switch on the AC or have chilled drinks when you have fever. Then you dash speak loudly. You dash speak loudly with your teacher. And what is that? You must not. And you dash treat animals cruelly. You ought not. And he dash hunt down or shoot animals because he will be punished by law. Then you mustn't hunt down or shoot animals. Then she dash hide important facts from her parents. She ought not to hide important facts from her parents. And absence of a necessity needn't have, then didn't need to, like that. You needn't have brought your car. You have brought your car, but actually there was no need to bring it. She didn't need to bring her car. She didn't bring her car because she thought there was no need to bring it. Fill in the blanks with the needn't or have or didn't need to. Then here, I have got an extra pencil. You dash take out your broken pencil. So I have got an extra pencil. Then I have got an extra pencil and you didn't need to take out your broken pencil. He dash a pack of woolen clothes for his trip to Jaipur because it would be warm there now. Then next one, he didn't need to pack woolen clothes for his trip to Jaipur because it would be warm there now. I have an extra copy of this book. You dash bought a new one. I have an extra copy of this book. Then you needn't have bought a new one. There were clean glasses on the shelf. You dash wash the dirty ones. There were clean glasses on the shelf. You needn't have washed the dirty ones. She dash buy a new mobile because she already has one. She didn't need to buy a new mobile because she already has one. Now wish may is generally used to express a wish. May you be blessed with good health. May you be blessed with all the happiness. Now dare, I daren't go into a dense forest at night. Dare you enter an old deserted palace all alone. I daren't challenge the boxer to fight with me. Dare means not to be afraid, to do something that requires a courage. And it is mostly used in negative sentences and in questions. Now fill in the blanks with the may or dare not. Here, you have a very successful career. What is the may you have a very successful career? That is the wishing. Second, I dash go near the crocodile as it is dangerous. I daren't go near a crocodile, near the crocodile as it is dangerous. Then dash you go near the injured snake? No, I. Then dare you go near the injured snake? No, I daren't. Then dear son, dash you have a bright future. May you have a bright future. Then the last one, all your wishes be fulfilled. May all your wishes be fulfilled. Yes, children, finished. Bye.